ladies and gentlemen, welcome. My name's Rob.
I'm Sierra.
And we have officially been living in South Korea for 6 months now.
Mm-hmm.
And in 2 days, it'll be 6 months.
Yeah.
That's crazy. So since we've been here, we've kind of explored, we kind of figured out that we don't have to miss out too much on the fast food places, the coffee shops that we love and know back home, because they got them here too. And in this list, we're gonna give you five of the places that is an American restaurant that they have here in South Korea that you can look forward to having a taste of home when you come. Let's get to it.
So number one is my personal favorite, Baskin Robbins.
Yeah, they have those everywhere actually. Like, there's a lot of Baskin Robbins all over South Korea.
Yeah.
If we can just walk like 5 minutes from our house, we will find a Baskin Robbins either way down the street that we go. Yeah. They love it. But they have some really unique flavors.
Yeah.
We had some that was kind of crazy tasting, and one of them was like a goopy ice cream with a rice cake in it. What was that one called?
Good chemistry.
Yeah, it was really weird. It was an odd consistency, almost, and not to gross you out, but it was almost like a boogery consistency. It wasn't a bad taste. It just was a weird consistency to it, right?
It was definitely boogery.
But they at least have my favorite, which is Jamocha Almond Fudge.
Yeah.
You can get some Baskin Robbins while you're here in South Korea. Number two, McDonald's. So actually, when we first got here, we overheard a conversation between one of our friends and another lady saying that there wasn't gonna be any kind of chicken nuggets or any kind of McDonald's, anything like that here in South Korea. So make sure your kids, you know, understand that.
Yeah.
But that's totally not true.
Yeah.
We have seen chicken nuggets at McDonald's, Burger King, like a whole bunch of different restaurants. They even have their own fast food restaurants here
and that are very similar.
Yeah, and their French fries. Oh my gosh, there's this place called Mom's Touch Guys that has the best French fries. Sorry, McDonald's, we're back to you. So McDonald's, they have McDonald's here and they have the great sandwiches you know and love. There's also, again, some new flavors.
Mm-hmm.
They have a shrimp burger here
that's
actually made of shrimp. It's not like this shrimp paste that's just formed into a patty. It's actually shrimp inside of a little
patty.
Yeah, thanks. A little patty, and it's like deep fried, kind of like popcorn shrimp. It's really good.
Mm-hmm.
So they have those, and of course they have your Big Macs if that's what you're into.
And bulgogi burgers.
Oh yeah, and bulgogi burgers. You're right. Thanks for saying that. Because these bulgogi burgers, if you guys come here, you go to South Korea, you're gonna have bulgogi at some point.
Mm-hmm.
And bulgogi is normally like thinly sliced meat. You can grill it or however you want to cook it.
Mm-hmm.
But these are patties of bulgogi, and it's honestly like a sausagey consistency, right?
Like a sausage patty.
It's like a sausage patty, really, and then it has like this bulgogi flavoring on it. And it's really good, but it's different. Be prepared for that.
Yeah.
All right, now for number three, what do we got?
KFC. This one actually surprised me because I didn't know, like, it's Kentucky Fried Chicken. Like, in Korea? Is it Korea Fried Chicken?
It seemed like it, for sure. So we went to KFC the first time and we had chicken, but we ordered, because a lot of places here have kiosks, okay?
Mm-hmm.
You don't really see a server much. You don't talk to a server much except for to get your food. But you go to this kiosk and you order, and this was all, there was no English option this time.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of places have English option, this one didn't. And so we kind of tried to pick just normal fried chicken, and we end up getting a soy sauce fried chicken.
Yeah.
And it was not what we were expecting, but it was not the Korea or Kentucky fried chicken that we're used to. So
dry, crispy chicken. It's like
this thing was soaked in soy sauce. It was so weird.
Yeah.
But it was a fun experience. So try some of the new stuff if you're gonna have KFC while you're here as well.
Mm-hmm.
They have the good stuff that you're used to from back home, but also try some of the new stuff. So moving on to the next one, and it's actually my personal favorite, and that is Starbucks. There's a Starbucks everywhere. They love coffee here. There's a lot of Baskin Robbins, but there's even more Starbucks and these places called Tom and Tom's. These guys drink coffee all times of day, and it's fantastic.
Yes.
If you're looking forward to your Starbucks, go get some. Now, it is a little bit different because you can't really make all the customizations as much here in Korea as you might be used to back home with each of your drinks. There's still some really good stuff. They don't have my personal favorite, which is a black and white mocha.
Mm-hmm.
It's called a tuxedo. They don't have that here, sadly, but I just kind of stick with my white mocha, and it's good either way. So guys, get yourself some Starbucks while you're here as well.
And number five is gonna be Subway. Not Subway, but Subway.
So Subway here is really good. It's really the same. There's not really a lot of difference, is there?
No.
So the only issue with Subway here is that it can be hard to really order, because at Subway, you've got to have a lot of communication. You've got to tell them exactly every ingredient you want on your sub, right? So make sure you use a good translation app. Now, if you're looking for a good translation app, check out my top 5 apps video. We're gonna link it up in the card, and I gave you one of the best translation apps on there. But if you're gonna order Subway, go use a translation app to order, make it easy on yourself if you don't know Korean. All right, guys, that's our top 5 food places from America that you can enjoy while you're here in South Korea. I hope you guys liked this video, and if you did, make sure to hit us with that thumbs up. And if you really liked it, what can they do?
Subscribe!
Bye, guys. We have officially been in South Korea, living here for over 6 months now. And I think it's about time that we clear up some myths, some stigmas that I know I heard about before I came to South Korea. What do you say?
Sounds good.
Let's go.